first day of school is today in Sheboygan. Census workers return. Silver alert issued for Sheboygan man. These stories and more coming up on this edition of Community News Review.
This is Community News Review, service WSCS-TV, news content provided by WHBL.
I'm Maddie Pfister, and this is Community News Review for Tuesday, September 1st, 2020. The SARS-CoV-2 virus has claimed another life in Sheboygan County, as reported in Monday's update by the Sheboygan County Division of Public Health. The deceased individual is only known to have been a person between the ages of 70 and 79, and becomes the ninth victim recorded here in the pandemic. One of the other eight individuals was in their 40s, three were in their 60s, another two, besides the most recent casualty, were in the 70s, and two were 80 or older. The confirmed case counts of COVID-19 in the county now stands at 1,071, with 12 cases added Saturday, four on Sunday, and another 39 as of Monday afternoon. A gain of 55, 34 persons have recovered since Friday, yielding a net gain of 20 active cases. That is a total of once again risen above 100, which is 108. Of those active, seven are hospitalized with 843 negative test results since Friday. The positive rate here now is 6.1%. The county DPH realized its first issue concerning the risk association with schools in Sheboygan County, a feature that will be updated each Friday, but was not initiated until today. Three metrics are considered when assessing that risk level: epidemiology, which considers the state trajectory of positive results, the Sheboygan County activity level, and the ability to test those who need it. Healthcare, which is based on the ability of hospitals to treat all patients without resorting to crisis standards and having adequate protective gear for each personnel. Public health, that being that every resident who tests positive is interviewed within 24 hours of the test results, and that contacts interviewed within 48 hours. Based on those metrics, the high school risk level status is high, and the guidance for responding to that designation is linked in the daily update from County DPH. The state of Wisconsin, which updates 7 days per week, added 266 positive cases today versus 3,552 negative, yielding a positive rate of 7%, and that is a 3 to 1/3% drop since Sunday, but the 7 day average remains stubbornly above 8%, and no deaths were included in today's update, suggesting that Sheboygan County fatality occurred earlier in the week. 13 more hospital state residents entered the hospital for treatment since Sunday. Now among 287 persons with COVID-19 being institutionalized for their symptoms, 104 are in the ICU, and another 154 persons with symptoms are awaiting test results. Meanwhile, 335 persons are on ventilators for the respiratory disease. Drivers will want to you to avoid using North 15th Street for a few days as repairs are done by the Department of Public Works. That from the Streets Division of Head David Groves. The area of concern is between North and Mayflower Avenues. Weather permitting, that project could be completed by 4 p.m. today, and traffic will be rerouted to the North 13th Street for the duration. After closing the last school year in a cloud of uncertainty, Sheboygan Area School District administrators spent the summer dispelling that cloud. And now the first semester of the new session will begin on today, both online and in person. A hybrid learning plan was instituted, guided by input from over 3,500 district parents. The plan allows more classes to meet in person with 18 or fewer students in the program. While the 4K program will group 10 to 15 students together at a time, since social distancing children of those ages is difficult. Elementary school will rotate their teachers in order to limit a student crossover in a 5-day week schedule. While middle and high school classes will stay in the same class cohorts, meeting in person 2 days a week, either Monday and Thursday or Tuesday and Friday. With other online learning the other 3 days. The SASD is also offered an entirely online capable for those who are uncomfortable with the in-person learning. And the district will be working closely with the Sheboygan County Division of Public Health to act if a virus outbreak occurs in the learning to transition online for the time it takes for the outbreak to be under control. The Sheboygan Area School District serves 10,000 students in 26 schools. Census workers will be back in the field to collect as many responses as possible for the count of the country's population fields. Operations have been on hold for the Census Bureau during the coronavirus pandemic. And if a census worker cannot reach home or reach you at home or on the phone, there are other places like some grocery stores, food pantries, and census workers are available. The census members influence the amount of federal dollars available to communities, as well as determining the number of congressional representatives. And the Sheboygan County Sheriff's Department is asking to help find a man with Alzheimer's who went missing on Sunday night. 38-year-old Armando Rodriguez was last seen in the 4700th block of Hunter's Glen Drive on Sheboygan's north side around 9 p.m. on Sunday. He has Alzheimer's, and deputies have been out all night searching for Rodriguez. If you have any information, you are asked to call the Sheboygan Department or 911. And finally, anyone entering Sheboygan County from the Western Highway on Highway 23 cannot get help but notice the Sheboygan County Veterans Memorial just east of the Taylor Reservoir. The project was initiated in June of 26 years ago this month, honoring the service and sacrifices of the country's veterans whose names are engraved on the mountain. Besides being honored, those who have lost their lives in service to the country names all others who have served and come home. I have each October since 2015, and deadlines to submit names for this year is September 15th. A majority of requests from engraving have usually been received annually at the Sheboygan County Fair, but with that event canceled, submission are now being accepted online, and those wishing to fill out that application can do so at scvmemorial.org. That is scvmemorial.org. And that is all we have for today. Join me again on Thursday for more local news and information on Community News Review.
News content for this program provided by WHBL in cooperation with WSCS-TV.